Abba.
Oh yeah, make we go
to Dhudhu's kitchen.
Hey, yeah, yummy. Oh yeah, make we go
to Dhudhu's kitchen.
Killeri.
Mimi tonje abadu tumbe abuja de umbe. For your delicious meal.
It's welcome back to my kitchen. This is Dhudhu's kitchen. It's nice to have you all here again today. We thank God for life. We thank God for family. We thank God for peace. So I want to appreciate all those who are subscribed to my channel. Thank you, everyone. I appreciate you so much. And for those who are here to do that, please subscribe to my channel, like and share with families and friends. In this channel, what do? We have fun cooking Nigerian dishes and sometimes continental dishes also. I want to say a very big thank you to all my subscribers who are non-Nigerians. I hope you are trying my recipes and styles. They are very nutritious and nice. So I want you to please try them. And so today, what am I going to be making? I'll be making Ofe Olugbu. Yes, that is bitterleaf soup. It is for the Igbos. The Yorubas, we usually use the bitterleaf to cook egusi soup and some other things. But the Igbos, they have a lot of soup. And in my house, we eat a lot of Igbo soup, even though I am not Igbo. But we eat a lot of their soup. And today, I will be making the Ofe Olugbu. So what am I going to be using? I'll be using snail. This is the thickener. It is ede. They call it ede in Igbo, which is, what do they call it again? I'll remember the name in Yoruba. I'll tell you what it is later. And then this is, you know, stock fish. This is Mangala fish. This is Asa fish, see Asa, and then this is goat meat. I already boiled this and then I grilled it. And then this is the normal whitening. This is like smoked, it is smoked dried. And I have my pepper, which is as usual, you know what I put there. If you've been part of this wonderful family, it's bell pepper, Scotch bonnet, tomatoes, onions, garlic and ginger. And then I have here the bitter leaf. You see it? It came in dry. So what I did was I had to cook it a little using my pressure cooker. I cooked it a little, and then because my husband doesn't like the long strings of the bitter leaves, I had to cut it into pieces. And then I remember the name of this is cocoyam. And in Yoruba, we call it coco. So, cocoyam. So, this was sent by a friend, Vivian. Thank you. So, I'm using this. It is a thickener. If you don't have this, you can always use the Achi. It's also very good for it. So, what I'll be doing right now, and I also have my palm oil, lest I forget. And then, my Cameroon pepper. This is spicy. You can always get all this in Nigerian, African markets or African stores. But I did get mine from Nigeria. There is Asam company. This is what they do. The fish, I got all of them from them. They can ship anywhere all over the world. I will leave their contact number in my description, in the description for this video, so you can look at it later and order from them. It can stay up to 1 month. It doesn't get spoiled and it's reasonable, so try them. All right, let's get started. Go wash all this. After washing the fishes, then I'll start boiling. I'm going to boil them in the same stock or broth that I boiled the goat meat. So let's get started. I'm gonna put the snail. This is everything, the fish, everything is in here. So you see I didn't mention onions. No, I didn't put onions again because I already have onions in the stock that I'm cooking it with, like I said earlier, for the goat meat that I made before. So this is my crayfish, blended crayfish. This was blended by me, so I didn't have to wash it like I always do. So now I'm gonna put water. So if you want to enjoy the fish, all the fish that I brought from Nigeria, it's better you put them in water overnight so that they can become soft, or you can always use your pressure cooker to cook them until they become very soft. So mine is now soft, so the next thing I'll do is I'll just cover this up for about 5 more minutes to 10 minutes more, and then that's gonna be ready. It should be well done properly now. You see it? So the next thing I'm going to do is I'll pour this pepper and then put some water. I would also be putting the goat meat. So I'm going to put more water. So now I will be putting the bitter leaf. Why I'm putting it now is because it's not really soft, it's not totally soft. So I'll put that in, and then my ede, which is the cocoyam thickener, I would mix it with water. But I won't put it now, I'll just mix it, because I don't want it to have lumps, and that's why I'm mixing this right now. You see it, that's the lady. Okay. I'll just mix this properly. And then I'll still put a little bit of water, because this usually takes water, a lot of water. So this is using Dhudhu's kitchen method and style. Please try it. You will be glad you did. I just have a taste of this right now. Just to be sure it doesn't need salt or pepper or Maggi. So I'm going to put a little bit of salt, because I see it doesn't have enough salt. And then I'll put water. So I'll season this with one cube of Maggi, and then I'll cover it. So like I said, for my stock fish, for my Asa fish, for my Mangala fish, for catfish, I didn't put catfish here today because I substituted the catfish with my goat meat. You can put anything you like in this. So for my catfish, for the whitening, you can get them from 8 Sam farm. They have their farm, and it is reasonable, it is cheap. It can stay on for shipping 1 month, 2 months, it will get spoiled. It is very, very good. So I want you to please try them and let me have your comments. I'll put all their details in the description box. Okay, See you in 10 minutes. Okay, so now this should be done. Oops. Yeah. You see? Everything is done properly. So what I will do now is I'll put the edi. That's my thickener. And then I'm going to put in the oil. This is palm oil. I'm not putting too much. That's like 2 to 2.5 cooking spoons. You see, it's getting thicker gradually. So I'll put a little bit of water just to rinse my plate. Okay. And then the last thing I'm going to put is my Cameroon pepper, because I usually put this so that I can always perceive the odor, the nice smell of the Cameroon pepper. So I want it a bit spicy, and that's why I'm putting that much in it. The soup is almost ready. And guess what? I made my eba. You can eat this with any swallow, eba, fufu, pounded yam, amala, whatever you want to eat it with. It's really, really nice with it. So now I'm just gonna taste this to see how it is, because I added a little bit of salt earlier. It's nice, and then the bitter leaf has that bitter sweet taste, you know. So it's getting thick. I'll just put a little bit of water. Wow. Oh God, this is nice. See? Wow, see? I can't wait to eat this. So I just cover it for 5 minutes and then it is ready. So this is done now. You see it? You see that it is thick. It's not too watery. Can you see the consistency? It's not too watery. It's not too thick. So, this is the Olugbu using Dhudhu's kitchen styles and recipes and methods. That's it. So I'll dish this out right now, and then you see the final look. For those who have yet to subscribe, please subscribe. For those who have subscribed, thank you so much. I appreciate you. So see you in a jiffy. So this is the end result of my Ofe Olugbu. That is the bitter leaf soup using cocoyam as a thickener. You see it? Isn't this nice? Some people will buy cocoyam and cook it till it is so soft, and then mash it and use it as a thickener. So you can also do that if you can see cocoyam anywhere you are. For people in diaspora, you can also see cocoyam, but if you can't, use achi or you use ede, the blended cocoyam, just like I did. You see how it looks? I tell you, this tastes wonderful. See it with my back. Look at it. Very, very Nice. I'm sure you like this portion. Yeah. So thank you everyone for watching. I appreciate you all. Thank you so much. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe to my channel, like and share with families and friends. And if you have, I say a very big thank you to you. God bless you. You see, cooking is fun, right? Isn't it? Very, very nice. Thank you again. And for those who sent me messages that they want to see my face, don't worry, you'll see my face very soon. Just a limited time more. So thank you so much. Have a wonderful week. Bye. God bless you. See you next time. Bye.